I guess our courage came out of because we didn't have nothing, that we couldn't lose nothing. But we wanted something for ourselves and for our children. And so we took a chance with our lives.
We marched up the steps with this circle of soldiers with bayonets drawn. And walking up the steps that day was probably one of the biggest feelings I've ever had. I figured I had finally cracked it.
My freedom is very much entangled with the freedom of every other man. So I'm fighting for my own freedom here.
Are you scared?
Yes, I'm very much afraid. Everyone here is.
In a 10-year period, in the 1950s and 1960s, America fought a second revolution. It was fought in the South by black people and white. It was fought in the streets, in churches, in courts, in schools. It was fought to make America be America for all its citizens. These were America's civil rights years.
I take it then that you are advocating Negroes in New York to stay out of these national chain stores.
Oh, no, that's not true. I'm advocating that American citizens interested in democracy should stay out of chain stores.
I have fought for a long time that Negroes should be allowed to sit at the counters where we are served downtown. This is just a part of many things that I think they should be allowed to do.
All the people of the South are in favor of segregation. And Supreme Court or no Supreme Court, we are going to maintain segregated schools down in Dixie.
We're willing to be beaten for democracy, and you misuse democracy in the street. You beat
people. Why don't you get out in front of the camera and go on?
It's not a matter of being in front of the camera. It's a matter of facing your shirt and then hide your blows.
Go on.
It was a clear engagement between those who wished the fullness of their personalities to be met and those that would destroy us physically and psychologically. You do not walk away from that. This is what movement meant. Movement meant that finally we were encountering on a mass scale the evil that had been destroying us on a mass scale. You do not walk away from that, you continue to answer it.
I always think of what Matthew Jr. told me. And when he called from the jail, he said, "Be cool, mother." And that was very trying, and yet it was amusing too. He's telling me to be cool at this point.
Come to see that the end we seek is a society at peace with itself, a society that can live with its conscience. And that will be a day not of the white man, not of the black man. That will be the day of man as man.
It was a hard fight, challenging America's basic beliefs. What is an inalienable right? What is equal treatment under the law? What is liberty and justice for all? It was a hard fight, but the prize was freedom, and no American could afford to lose.
I know the one thing we did right.
Hey!
Was the day we started to fight. Keep your eyes.